Hey everyone, welcome to Fabulous Friday at the Friendly Real Estate Group. My name is Jeff Ragan. I am the owner and the broker of this lovely company based here in Tallahassee, Florida. I'd like to thank you for visiting me today. And as I do every Friday, I'm bringing you a video on the real estate market here in Tallahassee, Florida. And as I promised in last week's video, and if you look around somewhere up in here, you'll see a link to last week's video, because I talk about my own personal story of moving here to Tallahassee, Florida. But anyway, I just wanted to, I promised in last week's video that I would show you a personal home tour working with a couple that's living out of state looking to move here to the Tallahassee area. So I took a video and of this tour of a home, and I want to show it to you. So let's get started right now. Again, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I so appreciate it when you come here each week as I make these little videos. You know, this, who's this old, bald-headed, overweight, crazy guy in Tallahassee, Florida, who calls himself a realtor, a broker by chance, that is making these videos to help you to be able to understand a little bit more about the real estate market in Tallahassee, Florida. I find myself working with lots of out-of-state buyers as well as other buyers from out of town that are living already in Florida. We do have a pretty big migration of people moving north from South Florida. And then of course we have many people moving here from out of state because of the weather is obviously a big draw, but the low tax environment that we have and other things. So I've got other videos on that that we'll talk a little bit about the benefits of retiring here in Tallahassee, Florida, or living here, even if you're not retired and working from home. So anyway, this week, as promised, I'm going to have a video that is going to be an actual home tour that I did for Bruce and Veronica. We wrote a contract and we went in and I toured the home. And it's going to be, I try to make it as much as like a personal experience that you would have if you were just coming in for the first time. And so I don't really do anything other than try to shoot it in the order that it would have happened in real life, so that you can see the doors drive up in the driveway, see the doors open, see the lights get turned on, and etc. I so appreciate your visiting my YouTube channel. And again, please subscribe to my channel, ring the bell so that you can be sure not miss a single video of this old crazy guy here in Tallahassee. And also, if you don't mind, if you watch this to the end or even now, smash the old thumbs up button, because YouTube gets the idea, hey, you know what? I think people might like this guy, and stay here and watch as many of my videos on the channel as you would like. So again, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy this tour. It was done at a different day and time. However, I have done these videos before for others, and I save them, and I thought, you know what, this would be a great time. So next week, what I'll do is I'll actually share with you the actual results. Did the seller accept our offer? Well, you got to come back next week to find out. So enjoy this home tour, and let's talk again next week. Thanks. Hey there, Bruce and Vicky. This is Jeff with Friendly Real Estate Group. I have just turned off of the Shady Rest Road, and I'm now on Gus Burt Farm Road. So I'll go ahead and let you enjoy a little bit of this drive, but it's about a half a mile back to the house. So this is a private association, I guess, but it doesn't look to me like they do a whole lot with the roads, but a little bumpy. But just so you can get an idea what the houses look like back here, so forgive the bumpiness. Camera moving around. That'll give you an idea of some of these houses. There's another one for sale. It's probably sold because it looks like the people are moving out, but I'll have to check on it. So it's pretty much a single lane road. But you can see the style of homes.
nice homes.
Obvious Trump supporters. And I am going to be at the house in just a second. Okay, I'm at the driveway now. It's just a little cul-de-sac, gravel. But this house is at the very end of it, which you probably already discovered when you did your search. This is the house and the yard. That roof looks fairly new. A little bit of a shed here. So let's go take a look at the house. Okay, I'm in the front yard looking out to the driveway, and just to do a little pano of the yard. It's a well-kept home, nice yard. I'll just kind of go all the way around. I'll do like a 360 degree turn. Very private, being at the end of a cul-de-sac. Certainly appears to have some very nice landscaping done. Let's walk up to the front door. And one moment, we'll be inside. Okay, so I'm at the front door, and he did tell me that they're doing some work on the floor here. You can see where there's some stain. It looks like it may be water intrusion, but he did say something to the effect that they've had a cat, and the cat has peed on the door, so the door is a little bit rusty. And it is oak floors. Yeah, so that explains it there.
So you can see that this door is being replaced according to the realtor.
Built-in bookcases right here as I walk in the front door. Pretty nice. And as I want to go to the right, so this time I'm going to do a little bit of a counterclockwise. So this is what I guess you would call a formal dining. Large room. Into the kitchen. The floors in the kitchen are in good shape. It's a solid surface top. I think it's like a corian. Refrigerator, stainless steel refrigerator. Another counter sink. A beautiful glassing like pantry. Yes, for dishes. Microwaves under the counter. Cabinets. appear to be solid wood, except for this is not solid wood. I think that's a material that it's like a vinyl covered wood or something, particle board. Here's the other door. He told me that we have to look past that. They're replacing the exterior doors. Again, evidently because the cat was peeing in here a lot. It doesn't smell strong though, so maybe the cat's been gone for a while. This is the laundry room. Little wash sink. And a shop. And this is the door going out to the side patio. Panel box. Definitely 200 amp service. There's a closet here next to it. Utility closet. Okay, remember I'm doing a counterclockwise rotation. I came in the door and I'm just staying to the right. So let's see if I can turn on some lights in here. In the living room. A wood burner stove here. Two great big glass doors. Go out onto a screen patio. Circle. I'm now going into a bedroom. Closet. So it is a tile floor in here. It's an older cabinet with a Formica top. I don't see a light in the shower, so it's a little dark. Put a bench in it. Looks like a... Oh, it's a closet. Walk-in closet. So this would probably be the master bedroom since it has a bathroom and a closet. Walk-in. This is the toilet room. And it has a little storage pantry here. Also. House is well maintained. No evidence of roof leaks. Of course, that roof, when I pulled up, I made a comment, looked fairly new. All right, so again, staying to the right, I'm making a counterclockwise navigation through. Then go out onto the deck. Very nice, large, screened-in deck. Out into the backyard. Looks like some thick woods. We got a mixture of probably oak and pine, both. There's a ceiling fan in here. Okay. And I'm going to proceed to the other opposite side of the house. As you know, this was a 3-2. Okay, this bedroom. Built-in cabinets. Nice. Still has a closet. Again, it's the oak floors are throughout the house. At the end of this hall with these two bedrooms is another bathroom. It's a Formica top, ceramic floor, and it's a ceramic tub area too. It's a tub enclosure, and it's a real bathtub, as I would say, because it's a cast iron tub. Those are solid as rocks. That's always good to know, because you can refinish cast iron tub if you needed to. And this is probably last bedroom. Hello? Don't want to walk in on somebody. It's a little scary thing about occupied houses. Similar to the other one, it's got a little closet, and then it has built-in dresser and shelves. Yes, the windows are double-pane windows. Probably original. This house was built, I think, in 91. So I'm suspecting these are original windows. They do have some halfway decent plantation blinds for the window coverings, which is always nice. Okay. I'm back out in the living room. So I did a complete counterclockwise rotation through this house. That's pretty much it. So I'll do a little walk around the yard, and you'll know what you got. You do have, I guess, just I want to mention here, the backsplash in the kitchen, as you can see, is a ceramic backsplash. I'm waiting for the seller property disclosure. The agent told me that we should have it shortly. Just remember, this is a coming soon, so it's not even on the market yet. The repairs are still to be made. That's why they're waiting to show it on June 1st. So that's it for the inside. I'll do a little walk around the outside. This deck outside looks like it's been replaced recently. I know he said there was some wood rot that they were fixing, and I believe the deck is part of it. It does appear to be on a crawl. Since I see events, I see more than one. I'm gonna walk around going the counterclockwise direction. You see lots of vents here. This is the back where it goes up to the screened-in patio. Full brick home. Boy, I tell you that. You can't beat that. The full brick home. This little area is fenced in here. I'm guessing they had small pets at one time. Give you an idea. I have shorts on and I don't really want to get poison ivy, but give you an idea of the woods. Remember, this is two parcels. The land is separate. So it has its own tax ID number. It does seem to taper down. As you can see, hopefully, I don't know if you can tell from this angle, but the land does kind of contour down. very dense woods. This is the entrance to the crawl. Condenser unit. Looks really good. Heating and cooling, so it's probably a heat pump. I'm guessing. I'm trying to get the label. I'll take a picture of that. Again, this is all part of the property that's for sale with this also. This is a little less dense. Smaller trees, probably could clear it out of that area here pretty easy. As you probably saw, this has some crazy property lines that zigzag, I should say, over there. Clockwise around the house. Pretty high and dry. Probably wouldn't be too much to clear some of that out to make a little pasture. That's what you're looking to do. And I'm back up to the front yard by the driveway. Pretty much it. I'll get a shot of the shed. Okay, so the shed does have electricity in it. And it's pretty much empty. I'll walk around behind it because there seems to be like a lean-to in the back of it. Still going counterclockwise. So basically, they just have some shelves back here with dirt, and the truss, it has trusses that's covered. Take a look at the woods here. Looks like they've carved paths. I see a few areas where there's some paths carved going into the woods. I don't want poison ivy, so I'll give you a little idea. I think we're still in the same property, woods. Again, Again, I see mostly pine. Going back up. That's it. One last little bit of a video. If there's any downside to this property, there's no garage. You got a few stairs going up as you bring groceries in the house and things like that. And then as far as the other thing, I guess, the shed itself, well, it needs painting. Doesn't look like a lot of wood rot on it, but it could use some maintenance. Other than that, it's just the road. The road's a little bumpy. I'm not sure what the HOA pays for, but they say it pays for the road. Don't look like they put any work into the road in a while. So that concludes the tour of this property. Again, you know, I can't see anything major. I'm thinking, I'm gonna look it up, but I'm thinking the AC system's probably fairly new. It's not as original, and the roof is definitely not original. And the house is all brick and in very good shape.